Hello everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to get started with the WPF DataGrid of Syncfusion. In this session, you will learn how to add a simple data grid to the WPF project and bind data collection to it. You will also learn its features such as auto size columns, filtering, grouping, sorting, and selection. So let's get started. In this video, I'll be using Visual Studio 2017 and here I have created a WPF project. Now let's see how to add the data grid control from the toolbox. In the toolbox, look at the Syncfusion WPF control section where you can find SF data grid. Toolbox will be configured with Syncfusion controls when you install Syncfusion WPF Essential Studio. If you are using NuGet, then Toolbox will show SF data grid once you install syncfusion.sfgrid.wpf NuGet in the project reference. I'll simply drag the SF data grid from the toolbox and drop it in the designer window. Now, I'll right-click the data grid and navigate to the layout option and click Reset All. So the data grid will occupy all the available window space. Here you can view an empty data grid in the window. To populate data in this empty data grid, I need to bind a data collection to it. SF data grid supports to bind any data collection that implements the IEnumerable interface. I have already created a model class named OrderInfo that contains the basic order related informations such as order ID, customer name, country, customer ID, and chip city, and created another class named ViewModel that contains the collection of type order info and sample data that will be added in the collection. Now, I'll show how to bind this collection to SF data grid. For that, in XAML, I'll set the Windows Data Context property to ViewModel. Now, I'll click the data grid to view its property window. I'll search for item source and click the button on the right side of the property. From this menu, I'll select Create Data Binding option, which shows a Create Data Binding dialog box. Let's bind the view model to DataGrid's item source by selecting this order collection and click OK. Now, I have successfully bound the data collection, so let's run the application to visualize the grid. You will see a simple data grid that displays the provided data collection in a tabular format. In this data grid, I haven't set any column width option, so the columns are generated based on the content in the cell. So let's close the application and see how the built-in column width options work in data grid. You can auto-size the data grid columns using the column sizer property. In the data grid's property window, search for column sizer and set it as star to divide the available grid space among the columns. There are other options like auto, which calculates the column width based on the header and cell content, and auto loss column fill, which works similar to auto except it fills the remaining grid space with the last column. Now let's visualize this column sizing changes on the grid. Here, you can see the data grid with the auto-sized columns that has its width equally distributed. I'll close this application to enable sorting features in data grid. There are advanced sorting features available in WPF data grid like multi-column sorting, tri-state sorting, showing the sort order in column header, and sorting records based on custom logic. Sorting feature is enabled by default in data grid. In case if you want to disable this feature, search for allow sorting and disable it. Next, search for other tri-state sorting and enable it. Next, enable show sort numbers. Now let's run the application to view the sorting behavior. So, to sort the column against one or more columns, I'll just need to click the concern column header. For example, here I'll click the order ID column header, and you can see the contents in that column getting sorted in ascending order. And when I click again, you can notice it getting sorted in descending order. When I click again one more time, then data order gets reset to its original state since I have enabled the allow tri-state sorting option. You can also sort more than one column in the data grid. For example, I'll click the order ID column header. Now, I'll press the control key and click the customer name header. You can notice here that the customer names are sorted based on the sorted order ID. You can also see the sort order in the column header. Since I have set the show sort numbers option to true, I'll close this window to enable grouping options in DataGrid. Using DataGrid, I can group the data either based on one or more columns. Grouping is enabled by default. In case if you want to disable this feature, search for allow grouping and disable it. In DataGrid's property window, search for show group drop area property and enable it. Now let's run the application to see how grouping works. Here I can group the data against one or more columns. To start grouping the data, I'll simply drag the column header and move it upwards. Now you can see the group drop area UI expanded at the top. Let me drop the column header there, and you can view the data getting grouped based on the identical values in that column. You can also view the grouped items by clicking the expander button in the data grid. You can also group more than one column. If you want to remove the grouping, either drag the column header back to the data grid or click the cross button that will appear when you hover over the grouped item. Let's close the application and see how to enable filtering feature in DataGrid. I can filter the data programmatically using predicates and can use the two built-in UIs, namely Advanced Excel-like Filtering UI and the Filter Row UI. Here I'm going to explain only about the Excel-like filtering UI, which can be opened by clicking any column header. In DataGrid's property window, I'll search for allow filtering and enable it. Now let's run the application to view the filtering behavior in DataGrid. You can filter the data in DataGrid using Excel-like UI with checklist box and advanced options. To filter data, you need to click the filter icon that is visible at the top of every column header. For example, I'll click the filter icon in the order ID column. And let me check few items. Now you can see the DataGrid displaying only the selected items. In the same way, you can also filter the items in DataGrid based on certain conditions. In order ID, I'll select greater than criteria and choose a value from it. You can now view that the DataGrid displays only the value greater than the selected value. I'll close this application and let's explore the selection behavior in DataGrid. There are different selection modes available in DataGrid to select both the grid rows and cells. By default, you can select a single row, but you can modify this behavior by changing the value in selection mode property. In the data grids property window, search for selection mode and you can view few selection types. Multiple and extended allows you to select multiple cells. For example, I'll select extended and let's run the application to visualize the change in the selection behavior. Now I can select multiple items either by dragging the mouse over the required cells or by pressing Shift plus up arrow key to select cells in the upward direction or Shift plus down arrow key to extend downward selection. Now let me close this application to enable cell selection. In the data grids property window, look for selection unit and select cell option from it. Now let me run the application to see how the cell selection can be performed in data grid. Now you will be able to select cells in the data grid. So we have seen how to include data grid in WPF project, how to bind data collection and perform data operations like how to filter, group, sort and select data in data grid. Thank you for watching this video. If you find this video as useful, hit the like button and subscribe to our channel.